Hey guys, Chris Fix here, and today I'm going to show you how to aim your headlights so you have the optimal lighting pattern without blinding other drivers. I'm going to quickly show you the main steps to get your headlights aligned during the day so you can clearly see what needs to get done at night. The first step is to identify where your adjustment screws are on your headlight. My headlights have two adjuster screws, one up here and one down here. Typically, headlights are not this much of a pain to adjust. Some headlights have bubble levels and easy-to-read adjusters that make this job so much easier. Some headlights have a center mark built into the adjuster screw so you know where zero is, and then when it's zeroed out, you could adjust it either +1 or -1 or +2 or -2. My truck's headlights are pretty bare bones, so there's no zero-out mark or adjuster bubbles or any of that stuff. Either way, this method I'm about to show you will work for any headlight on any car or truck. And just to be clear, some adjuster screws on some headlights could be turned by hand. In this case, I need to use a tool. Sometimes you could use a flathead or a Phillips head screwdriver or even a ratchet. But in this case, this is a 4mm and you need a 4mm wrench, and I don't have a 4mm wrench. So what I'm going to use is a pair of narrow tip vice grips. And then I could just clamp onto the end here, get it on nice and tight, and then now this will just turn to either tighten or loosen. So that's how I'm going to adjust this top screw and this bottom screw. Hopefully your adjustment's a little bit easier than this. If not, I mean, you get to see how I did this. It's really nice when they give you something that you could adjust, like with a Phillips head screwdriver or a ratchet. A ratchet's usually the easiest. You know, you put your socket on here, you ratchet away to tighten or loosen it, and then this will adjust either up or down or side to side. So with my headlights, when you adjust that top adjuster screw, when you tighten it, the headlights will actually aim upwards a little bit, and when you loosen it, the headlights will aim downwards a little bit. The side bottom adjuster screw will actually adjust this headlight from the side to side position. When you tighten it, it's going to pull it that way towards the inside, and when you loosen it, it's going to push it outwards towards the outside of the car. So now that you know all the little adjustments on the back of the headlight and how to adjust the adjuster screws and what they do, you need to know the actual procedure for adjusting them. So let me go show you how to do that. So it's nighttime, and the next thing you're going to want to do is find a flat road and a flat wall. You can see this road, and actually it's a fence, meet at a 90 degree angle. So it's nice and square, and it allows us to project our headlights right up against this. You can find places where the wall and the floor meet at a 90 degree angle, and then you have plenty of space to work with in shopping malls. So the back of a shopping mall, that's where I am right now. So I have my level, and you can see how even the wall is here. Now we're gonna go look at the floor, and you can see there is a slight slope. If I lift this end up just millimeters, you can see it levels out. So really, that's not a big deal. Now we also wanna go back to our 25 foot mark, which is at the end of this long tape measure. And we want to see here as well if it's level, and you can see it's pretty level here. So that's good. We have a level wall and a level floor. For this test, you want to make sure that you have no extra gear in your trunk or in the bed of your car. You also want to make sure your gas tank is at least halfway filled. So now we're going to drive up to the wall, so we want to be as square to this wall as possible. So with the truck pretty close to the wall, we're going to take out our tape measure and we're going to measure the distance of each light to the wall to make sure they're even. So for the passenger side headlight, we are 20 5/8. So now the driver's side is actually too close compared to the passenger side, so I'm gonna have to back up and realign the truck. So now I just moved it again. We're gonna measure one more time, both sides. Now we have exactly 2 feet. Now we're going to go to the driver's side. So I have the tape measure in the same spot on the driver's side at the corner of the headlight. So that's 24 inches, which is 2 feet, which is the same exact distance as the other side. Good. Okay, now we know the truck is square to the wall. Now what we're going to do is we're going to pull the truck all the way up really close to the wall. And you want to make sure when you're moving up to the wall that you don't touch your steering wheel. Now, from now on, your steering wheel does not get touched. You back up, you'll back up straight. You go forward, you go straight. So now we are really close to the wall. Make sure you don't hit the wall, obviously. But this is good because now we'll be able to just put our tape right onto the wall where we need it to be aligned. So now you're gonna get some dark tape. I have some blue painter's tape. And what we wanna do is we wanna ignore the light pattern on here right now. Don't worry about the lights. And we're gonna mark the bottom of this headlight on this wall. So that height, whatever that height is, instead of measuring it with a ruler, we could just go right across like that. So now we're gonna shut the light. And the reason why we shut the light is because we don't wanna have our eye trained on this beam here. This beam is not accurate. Where this is not accurate right now. So I have this piece of tape that runs all the way from one side of the headlight to the other. And I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna go straight across. So you can see this tape is lined up with the light here. It goes right to the tape. So here's the bottom of the headlight. And when we go straight across, the bottom of the tape is exactly where the bottom of the headlight is. And the other thing is, our tape is level. You could do the same thing by measuring your headlight to the floor and then measuring the same distance from here to the floor. It does the same thing, but it's just easier just to have your headlight right here and use that as a reference. Now we're gonna do the same thing on the driver's side. So we're gonna cut our tape so it's the same length as the headlight, and we're gonna transfer it right to the wall. So if we look here, you can see bottom of the headlight, bottom of the tape, they're nice and even. So we have both of our tape marks in place. Now I have a ruler on the floor, and it goes all the way down to 25 feet. You want the headlight to be 25 feet away from the wall. So when the headlights are 25 feet away from the wall, we'll stop the truck. So now the front of our headlight is aligned with the 25-foot mark. Remember to shut off your fog lights and also have your low beams on only. You always adjust your headlights with low beams on only. If your high beams can be adjusted, you could do that later. But in this case, I only have low beams to be adjusted. And then your high beams kind of just adjust with that automatically. Now when comparing our lights to the marks on the wall, we could see we're off. I'm gonna cover the driver's side light, so that's just the passenger side light. So you can see that square that's right up there. The bottom of that square should be touching the bottom of that tape line. Now I'm gonna cover the passenger side light, and you can see that square right there. Well, the bottom of that square should be touching the bottom of that tape line right there. So we're gonna work on one light at a time. Since we did move the car, we're gonna check our measurements one more time to make sure that the headlights are square to the wall. And we're measuring to the bottom of the mark on the wall that we made. Just as before, we measured to the corner, and we're at 297 here. And then when we look at our measurement here, we're right at 297 again. So good, we're completely square to the wall. So I'm gonna block the passenger side light first, and we'll work on the driver's side. Make sure if you do cover your passenger side, you don't cover it directly over the headlamp, because you could actually melt the lens. It'll get way too hot. So now what we're gonna do is we want the beam to be 2 inches below this line. So 2 inches is right here. So I'm gonna go move our piece of tape to that bottom line right here. There we go. So we need the bottom of our beam to be right there. I prefer the beam to be straight under the tape, but you could adjust either to the right or left of the beams up to 6 inches, depending on your preference. So you can see that square right there, that is our beam pattern, and we got the bottom of the beam right at the bottom of that tape mark. So we wanna lock that in right there. Good. Now we're gonna move from the driver's side to the passenger side. So now we want the light beam to be 2 inches below this line again. So right there, so we'll take our tape and just tape it off 2 inches below. And then we want the bottom of our light beam to be right there. This is the same process. Depending on your setup, this might take a little bit. Be patient, take your time. Okay, good. So that's exactly where we want it to be. Now we can lock everything in place, and we can check out both of our light patterns. Okay, this looks great. We have a nice cutoff here. The bottom of each of the beams touches the bottom of the tape, and each beam is centered on the tape for the most part. So now let's go for a test drive and see if the lights are aimed properly, if we like how they're aimed, and make sure we don't blind anybody on the road. Okay, I'm gonna leave those tape marks there just because if we have to come back, we don't have to measure the car and everything again. We could just line up our two lights with the bottom of the tape marks. So now we'll go for a ride. You can see that's high beam. So here's a car right here, and you can see this is literally perfect. perfect. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. But right at that car, you could see, there's my low beams, there's my high beams. So the cutoff for my low beams are exactly where the window of that car starts. So you could see there's the window up there, there's my low beams. That is literally perfect. That just goes to show you how well this system works. So now we're gonna go for a ride and see how well this lights up the road, make sure the beam pattern is good, the spread is good. We already verified that it doesn't get into the mirrors of other people's cars and into their windows, so our cutoff is just the right height. So this road's pretty dark, it does have some lights, but you can see it lights it up really nicely. Okay, so now we're back to where we were. And I actually like the light pattern on this, so I'm not going to adjust anything. If you want to change your light pattern at all, you want to adjust anything, now's the time to do that. Also, don't forget to remove the tape. We use tape instead of chalk or a pen or anything, so it's removable. There we go. And we are officially done. Hopefully this video was helpful. If it was, remember to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing. Now, the top tip for this video is we adjusted the headlights, but also don't forget about your fog lights. To adjust the fog lights, since we already have the beams of the headlights in alignment, we could use those beams to align the fog lights. So what we're gonna do, we have our headlights on right now, and we also have our fog lights on. I'm gonna flash the fog lights. And you can see how there's a gap in between the fog lights and the headlights where it's black, right there. Well, we wanna get rid of that gap. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the driver's side first. We're gonna go to the bottom one here, it's 8 millimeter. We need to go and unscrew this. So I'm gonna keep unscrewing this and you can see that fog light beam is going up and we just want it to meet the bottom of the headlight beam there, just like so. We don't want it too high. So with the passenger side fog light, same thing. We're gonna tighten that. You can see that beam is all the way down there, way low. That needs to get tightened a lot. So sadly, that's as much as I could adjust this fog light. It's completely maxed out. The previous owner did something, maybe he like hit something lightly and it bent the bumper down just a little bit. So I've always had this fog light aim a little bit lower, but you get the idea. So you want to make sure that your fog lights light up both the ground in front of your truck, but also fill the gap at the bottom of your headlights on low beam. So when you're about 25 feet away, you can see the fog lights blend perfectly with the headlights. Even the passenger side, which is a little low, blends really nicely. And now your fog lights are adjusted. So there you go.